Let's connect the jumper wire to 0 volts to ground, and on the output we have to get 5 volts, means high. Let's do it. As you see, I have low in my input, but I'm getting high on output. Let's connect the jumper wire to high, 5 volts power supply, and we are going to get 0 volts on the output. This is how the inverter circuit works. So let's start by connecting the BC547 transistor to the breadboard. I have placed it in a way in which my emitter is on the left side, then base and the collector on the right side. Then I will connect the emitter of the transistor to the ground. Good. Then let's use 2.2K resistor and connect it to the base of the transistor. And the other lead goes to a blank spot on breadboard. Then I'm going to connect my 100 ohm resistor to the collector of the transistor and to the positive rail of the breadboard. Here is my 100 kilo ohm resistor. I will connect it to the base of the transistor and to ground. Perfect. Now I'm going to use some jumper wires. So let's extend the collector of the transistor via this jumper wire. And let's put a load on the output. I'm going to use a LED and 100 ohm resistor. So the 100 ohm resistor will be connected to the collector, and the LED will be connected in series to the resistor. So the anode goes to the resistor and the cathode will be connected to the negative rail of the breadboard. And for input, I'm going to use a jumper wire and I will connect it to the other lead of 2.2K ohm resistor. So perfect. Now let's power the circuit. I have 5 volts on my DC power supply coming through the circuit. So the inverter circuit works in a way in which if you have a low in your input, you will get a high on the output, and vice versa. If you have a high in your input, you will get a low on output. Low in our experiments means 0 volts. So let's connect the jumper wire to 0 volts to ground, and on the output we have to get 5 volts, means high. Let's do it. As you see, I have low in my input, but I'm getting high on output. Let's connect the jumper wire to high, 5 volts power supply, and we are going to get 0 volts on the output. This is how the inverter circuit works, with using only a transistor, some resistors, and an LED and resistor, and current limiting resistor for output.